Hi guys. But that's the mods that made to it.
Sogfari.
Just doing a little video camo style. Hi guys. A really big monkey tagged me to do a video on my two favorite navigational aids, or two tips or tricks for navigation, something like that. I probably should have wrote it down before coming out here to do a video, but oh well. So thanks, really big monkey. Anyway, I'm not a huge navigational guru or anything. The one thing I do quite a bit, you know, on the weekends, because I do have a day job, is going out and finding things. Whether it's something I read about in a story about Oregon history, or something I found on an old map, or something, you know, some old timer told me about, you know, whatever. And so as a byproduct, I have a ton of maps. The one thing I will tell you about maps is if you want to save it and it's all folded up, unfold it and roll it up and put it in a tube, because it'll last far longer in a tube. Even if it's just sitting on a shelf, you want it on a shelf in a tube than folded up and the paper stressed. So this is my GPS. It's not a brand new GPS by any means. This thing's probably 10 years old. Still works completely fine. It's completely waterproof. I think it even floats. But it's just a Magellan Sportrack Pro. It does have downloadable topographical maps in it. I've pretty much got all of the state of Oregon downloaded into it, so I can tell you where the cord is if I want to add more maps to it. Probably somewhere in my computer desk. But this is pretty much the way I keep it. I always have a couple extra batteries. One thing about GPS is it won't do everything for you, and it won't always work. Anybody that tells you a GPS will always work has either never used one or they're selling GPSs. I mean, there's a number of reasons why they won't work. I mean, if you get heavy enough cloud cover, you know, dense tree cover, you know, if you're in a steep canyon or valley, or even up against a big cliff, you know, and you get different accuracy readings, and any GPS will tell you how accurate of a, or how good of a signal it's getting, and how accurate the reading's going to be. And, you know, you need to read the book, but mainly you need to go out and use one. Something that'll definitely teach you how to use a GPS is go to geocaching.com and start geocaching. And by that, I don't mean all the junk that's in city parks and towns and stuff like that. Although, you know, if that's your thing, then go for it. But using your GPS is the best way to learn how to use it and learn when it'll work, when it won't, and how reliable it is. But it is definitely a good tool. Don't get me wrong. This is my Silva Ranger. It's the one that I take when I in my pack. I don't use it with when I'm navigating, getting to a site, or trying to find access to a site. For that, I use these things, and I replace them periodically because they get thrashed. But these are benchmark maps. As you can see, Oregon Road Recreation Atlas. I've seen one for Washington. You know, I assume they make them for every state. thing that makes them really neat. And I just priced them at the store. They're up to about, you know, 20, 22 bucks a piece. Is, if you can see, it's got little grids on the picture of the state and numbers. Well, those are just page numbers. It's just that simple. So if you're over here in La Pine or somewhere around there, then you're looking for page 74, 75. And there it is. So they're really handy for getting to a site and navigating around. I've even used the real tiny roads when you don't have any map that's got anything for that. So they come in handy. This one's the 1998 version. I don't know what year that one is. Might even be the same version and just got thrashed. The other one is, I thought these were put out by the same company, but apparently they're not. This is a DeLorme, something like that. And it's basically set up the same way. It's got the little grid and just with a number in it, and that's the page. This one shows quite a bit more topographical stuff and the back roads. And this is more just regular paved roads, but it does have some topographical stuff. The other thing is, like, this was a Forest Service map, and the whole map is far bigger. Well, I take them and I color copy them, and then these are the ones that I take and go out and about. The big full maps basically never leave my house. So, just that'll save your maps too. These maps, Metzger maps, these things were great. As you can see, it's almost got a little cartoon look, but these had every goat trail and little nothing and a road, you know, that hasn't been used in 50 years is basically on this map. And they're out of business because it was basically a family business, and the old guys that kept up the maps, and I don't know how they got all that information, all that stuff, you know, it just went away because nobody wanted to pick up the family business. So it was a great loss, but I've got pretty much one of every county in Oregon, so I'm more or less set. You know, just that's just a tip, I guess. And it makes them much more manageable. I mean, this I can even stuff in a pack or something, and I'm not risking my big full map, which, you know, maps are starting to get expensive. They're adding up. Anyway, basically what you're looking through here is, you know, just my research notes and stuff like that. These big map books help keep everything together. You know, probably not the most organized thing, but, you know, if I'm going out on a trip, that's basically how stuff is going to be. I do try and use these old map cases. I don't know exactly, you know, they're supposed to be military map cases. You know, the problem with them is this one's a little small, as you can see. Even the copies get dog-eared and in it. It did have a little clear thing, but it's a pretty small, you know, section of map that you can put in here. And there's rooms for notes. And it does look pretty cool. It's a canvas and leather. So, you know, not bad. This was another one that I got, I think Sportsman's Guide. I don't know what the model or where it comes from, but I think it was like under $5. And I just ordered it, figured, you know, what the hell, maybe this will work. It looked to be a little bigger. And it is. And it's got a, where you can pretty much put a full page of a color copied map in here. The other thing, I don't know if you guys can see, I highlight specific areas that I'm going to see, because half the time I'm driving, bouncing around on a gravel road, and I'm trying to look, okay, where was I on here, looking for these BLM road numbers and, you know, stuff like that. So maybe a little more detail than you were looking for, but it does have some nice little pouches, and I do carry these are, I don't know if I can get it out, I sock these up to keep them from getting scratched, and probably should have got out of the sock before shooting a video, just like making a note about what the video was supposed to specifically be about, but there we go. Anyway, these are nice compass to work with maps, because, you know, when I'm up there and I'm getting twisted around, you need to know what direction's what. So that's what I got this for. And these are pretty cheap. They're, I don't know, under $20. And I basically just keep them with my map set or whatever I'm using. So, a little book for notes. Sometimes you gotta scribble down a BLM road number and stuff. You know, and I don't like to write them on the maps very often. Other thing that's not really necessarily a navigational thing, but if you do like to go and you know, find different things or historical things, it really helps to have, if you can see it, there you go, hi Franklin, an old dictionary, because, and you want an old one, because a lot of times on the old maps or in historical stories and things, they'll use terms that aren't used anymore. So it helps to look them up. The other thing in doing research, I'm sure you can pretty much get a book like this for whatever state or area you're in. It's Oregon Geographic Names. You can basically look up the name of a place, a river, a creek, you know, a mine, a town, whatever, and it'll give a little blurb, or sometimes a larger section, maybe a whole page, on why it's named that, you know, when it was named that, and a little bit about it. So it helps in doing research. That's just an old notepad. That's pretty much my navigational stuff. And I'm not sure if that's exactly what you were looking for in your tag, really big monkey, but that's what I use. So I'll catch you on the next video.